So I'm just going to do a quick video, a bit of a behind the scenes. JR Board, one of my groups, has bought a house that they are beyond gutting. I think they're now putting a new roof on it. So I'm just going to do a bit of filming with them, show you what they're up to, show you a bit of the house. Just so you get to see what we do other than deal with our shit. We do also do property as well to get financially free. So here we go. So there you go, there's the house. There's already a skip outside, so the gut's well underway. I think it was a 3-bed, 1-bath in a very funny sort of layout, and they're actually got planning permission in for a 5-bed HMO. So it's on a fairly busy road, but it's right next to Llantrysil in South Wales, so it's got a lot of potential for a really great HMO for working people. So we're just around the back of the property now, just give you a show. I don't know whether you can see this, but the roof is actually, it looks all right if you just glance at it, but when you really look, the fascia boards are upside down. We're not sure if there's felt on all of it, and there's two enormous chimneys that need to come down. So actually, I think we'll check with the guys, but I think they've decided to actually take it down, take the chimneys down and actually re-roof the building, because when you come and see inside, it's a pretty big mess in there, and they've taken all the walls out, all the ceilings, so you'll really be able to see what it looks like in its bare bones. But it's a classic thing of, oh yeah, it looks all right, and actually when you really look, it just isn't. Another little thing there, they've already got the planning application in. They actually had that, they had the architect and the guys come in, I think the day after they'd actually completed the purchase, so planning went in straight away. So although they've started the gut, they're not hanging around for any length of time other than they need to for the planning. So the planning's gone in, we'll see what happens. Stuff was already pre-planned before we got the keys, so they're really rocking and rolling very quickly. I think they only completed maybe 2 weeks ago, if that. Hey boys and girls, ladies and gents. It's just a quick video for anyone who thinks they have to do it all themselves. I don't know if you've tried that already, it doesn't work. One of the reasons we do joint venture masterminds and we literally joint venture on everything is because life's really tough and people are really busy. And the guys that you're about to see and the house that they're doing, there's no way any of them could do it on their own. They're all in full-time jobs, they've got kids, commitments, travel things, they've got a lot going on, and yet they're still doing a fairly big gut on a 3-bed house, turning it into a 5-bed HMO. And they all understand that they couldn't do it on their own. One of them lives in North Wales, one of them lives in Bristol, one of them lives in Hereford, and one of them actually lives just down the road from the property, which is really handy. And between all of them, they get everything done properly and still manage to have their full-time jobs and their lives. And when this house is done, it should net them about £800 a month for the rest of their lives, profit. So it's really worth it, and it's really hard to do it on your own. So if you're out there thinking, oh, I'd really like to get into property, but really thinking, how the hell do I do it? You've got to partner with people. You've got to work with people you trust. And I also really recommend you work with someone impartial. And I mean, that's the kind of thing I do. It doesn't have to be me, but you need to work with someone who coaches you and mediates and deals with you guys on the down days and the stressful days. This stuff's not easy. These guys will succeed, and they'll exceed, including everything they've had to deal with to get there. So if you are wanting to do it, but get a team together, work with people you know and trust, and have someone facilitate you so that when it does get tough, it doesn't all fall apart like most joint ventures do. So let's go in and see what's happening.
Wow.
Well, I think we can say it's pretty gutted. There's not a lot left. This was a livable house, well, sort of livable, wasn't it?
Yeah, you could have lived in it.
A couple of weeks ago.
Yeah.
And then we let Lee loose. And he made it unlivable. How long have you owned it for now?
3 weeks.
Wow, 3 weeks. And the planning application is already on the lamppost outside in the street, and it's already gutted. Awesome. Is this your first time here, Rob?
Yeah. Yeah, so exciting. Good to take it in and have a look at what's going on.
This really excites me. I've been trying to look at the history of Llantrysil, but the surveyor thinks that where you're standing, this is an outdoor stair. Mm. And if you look at the whole fireplace here, then there was a big fireplace here, and on the other side of the wall, you can see where there was an oven. And then upstairs, you can see where it's a single-storey property.
Oh, wow, yeah. So how old is that? Is this, did I hear right, it's like 200 and 100 years old. It's really old, isn't it? This house?
Well, I think it's 1800s. Somebody broke up that one day.
Cool.
To give us more
door in that. What do you mean?
Oh my God, oh my God. That was floor to ceiling rubbish. That was floor to ceiling rubbish.
Then it was gone.
And some guy came and said, £500 to take the lot, and we'd
whip
this hand
on. You know the guy that did Conway Road? He does stuff like that as well.
Yeah. There was...
Was it too far away?
Lee tried him and I can't remember why it wasn't.
Yeah, so that's cheaper than a skip, because this this full, full?
Lee and I was saying 4 or 5 skips for that, for how much was in there.
Wow. It's literally just below the window, isn't it? So all of that wall's damp. And all of this wall's damp in here as well.
So as you go up the stairs, on your right is the crack.
The crack!
The crack that caused the guys working on quite a lot of trauma.
Oh, that's quite a big crack, isn't it?
They stopped and moved away when they saw that.
I'm going to get a better view. Oh, that's quite a big crack. So I can fit my... Yes, that is a big crack.
Yeah.
Da-da-da-da! The things that we find when we strip back... the house. And what's the actual outcome of this crack is actually not a big deal, ironically.
They're just going to helibar it.
Yeah.
And, they're going to use helibar.
So they thought the house was going to fall down, but actually it's all right. And then if we pan around, there's not a lot. Woo! There's not a lot left up here. Looks smaller.
Yeah.
They're going to drop that the whole chimney then. That'll give you a nice amount of space. So this was 3 bedrooms and walls and things, and it's now just...
This guttering's a bit of a mess, that was sodden, and their chimney was...
Have we got another chimney? Where's the other chimney? Is it up on this wall as well?
The other chimney's...
Up there. So that's coming away.
Yeah.
And did we manage to keep the... We don't have to get rid of a window, is that right? Because the architect was clever. Right, so that's a little bedroom.
So it is a little bedroom. Ooh. So we're talking about just giving a bit more space at the top of the landing. So taking that out, across here to the edge of there.
Oh, okay. That's pretty. That's all right.
And then potentially the other way we could create a bit more space is just have
storage
a bit of storage back there.
That's a really good idea.
So this is where the bathroom's going to be. That was where the wall was. We're going to pinch a couple of inches so the toilet can go here.
Nice. I like it. Good visual representation. And what else is going?
Then there's going to be a bath here.
Yeah.
And a basin here.
Cool. I like it. And the boiler gone.
And the boiler gone. Yeah. And then a door that way down.
So you've got 2 bedrooms there, so each window is a bedroom basically. So you've got bedroom, bathroom in the middle, and then bedroom. But this bedroom's got 2 windows.
Yeah.